Nothing has ever been more appealing than products that let you in on the secret of that one weird trick. And before the ads filled your spam folder and your sidebars, the miracles were being sold door to door. In 1960, nothing was more fascinating and less understood by the general public than the unseen, waves and radiation, which made the perfect sales pitch for quack devices that promised to cure cancer, soothe arthritis, and irradiate your baby's milk. Which probably isn't good for little Mortimer. The new wave of electroquacktronics carried on the tradition of Dr. Albert Abrams, who realized two things. First, the most profitable path usually wasn't focusing on a particular ailment. It was on diagnostics, because that covered every possible problem, and it didn't have to provide any solutions. Second, the device's name and the appearance of complexity made the sale. Abrams theorized that electrons were the most basic element of life. He humbly called this the ERA, or the Electronic Reactions of Abrams. It was the dawn of radionics, which was more about flashing bulbs and lots of dials and knobs than any real science. In the early 1900s, all you had to do was drop an envelope in the mail that contained a bit of your blood on a piece of paper, and Abrams could diagnose any disease with his dynamizer. He even claimed he could diagnose by telephone. By 1921, he'd trained 3,500 operators in spondylotherapy, who then handed out diagnoses of cancer, syphilis, and whatever else sounded like something you'd really want to know you had. And he followed that up with the oscilloclast and the radioclast, which used energy to counteract the internal vibrations and malformed cells that made you sick. This was all fake. Even in 1960, federal and state food and drug inspectors were still seizing Abrams' devices and their clones, like the Electro-Metabograph and the pathoclast. Who knows how many thousands, or tens of thousands, died from misdiagnosis and untreated illnesses. So you take the foundation of radionics, which you couldn't see or feel, and then you tap into the mystery of the atom. And you might as well put that right in the name. Like the Atomotrone, which looked like a mini fridge that was meant to irradiate your food and drinks using colored lights and radio signals from a transmitter on the top shelf. You shut the door, push a button, and boom! That's actually pretty much what we do with a microwave. But the Atomotrone didn't do anything, despite costing the equivalent of $3,000 today. Except it did emit a weirdly strong shortwave radio signal from that transmitter, which created a mystery in San Bernardino, California. Residents said their radios and televisions weren't working, so the Federal Communications Commission sent out a truck to find the interference. It led them straight to an Atomotrone in somebody's house. But no quack device looked more impressive than the Electro-Metabograph. The world was about to enter the golden age of science fiction, and the Electro-Metabograph would have looked at home on the Starship Enterprise. And it made HAL 9000 look like a big doorbell. It was another classic that persisted into the 1960s. Operators turned, twisted, and fine-tuned any of dozens of knobs to attain exactly the right radio frequency that would penetrate your internals and kill cells, energize cells, calm or rejuvenate organs. Literally any medical intervention was fair game. And if the operator lined up vials of medicine in the front, the Electro-Metabograph could even select which one would be most effective for the patient. We know that radio waves just don't work that way. But the Electro-Metabograph, well, it didn't even have a radio transmitter inside it. And an entire classification of devices called radon emanators did exactly what their name promised. They exposed both food and drink to radon and imbued it with radioactive gas. Radon exists in indoor and outdoor air, and no level of radon exposure is 100% safe. But the United States Environmental Protection Agency draws the line for serious risk at 4 picocuries per liter. One device seized in California was meant to be filled with blood, which was subject to radon emanation for 24 hours and then injected back into the patient. Physicists said it would have no more effect than the beam from a flashlight. But the regular handling of the device, well, that could expose the user to 10 to 50 times more radon, radium, or uranium, whichever the device contained, than they could withstand in a lifetime. The Rado-Pad purportedly relieved arthritis pain, but it was really just a bag of dirt the inventor claimed contained uranium ore, priced at today's equivalent of $300. Most of the arthritis devices relied on electric heat, which actually does temporarily soothe arthritis pain. So look, who falls for this stuff? Over 60 years ago, popular science declared that it was the hopelessly gullible, and they cited a U.S. Food and Drug Administration employee as saying seized pseudoscientific devices tended to pop up in California, Florida, Arizona, and southern Texas. Wherever old people accumulate to enjoy a mild climate, these harpies appear. And that's also why the weird devices and those who provide them have been, and always will be, so difficult to track down. The people who drop hundreds or thousands of dollars are too embarrassed to come forward to say that they've been swindled, hoodwinked, or bamboozled by either a well-meaning but severely misguided false prophet, a fraudster, or someone who's just plain crazy. And in hindsight, yeah, they do look stupid. But the editors of popular science ignored the most critical factor in a human's desire for a fringe miracle cure: desperation. A lifetime of nagging pain, the fear and danger of an acute life-threatening illness? When a perplexed doctor throws up his hands and tells you to take two of these and call him in the morning? Or when conventional treatments aren't working, when your happiness or your life is on the line? What else can you do? Because when all else has failed, all you've got left is that one weird trick. See you in the future.